Hello, good morning student. Today we'll see about the next part of this unit, that is energy conservation. Energy conservation in boiler means how to, what are the different opportunity or the tips of energy consumption in boiler. In the very first unit we have seen the working function and construction of the boiler. This is a pulverized coal fired boiler, and this type of boilers are used in the thermal power plant to produce the electricity. The function of the boiler is, first we will see what is in my boiler. Boiler is the steam generator, or the function of boiler is to produce the steam from the water. Okay. Here, utilizing the heat energy which is get produced by burning the, which will get produced by burning the fuel or the oil, heat energy will get produced. That heat energy is supplied to the water, then water will get converted into steam. Then steam is used for the different purposes. In case of this pulverized boiler, this steam is generally used to produce the electricity. Means this steam is used to run the turbine. So little bit just we have summarized the working and construction of the boiler. Just little bit just we'll discuss a little just summary about the boiler, because we have seen already have seen this topic in the first unit. Construction of the boiler means boiler is consist of the different parts, that is drum, superheater, reheater, and economizer. This is air preheater. This is coal mill, bunker. Okay, so these are the different parts of the boiler. Again, on the remaining PA fan and FD fan, ID fan and chimneys are not shown here. So these are the different parts of the boiler. Number of cycles operate in the boilers. Coal cycle, flue gas cycle, air cycle, water cycle. So these are the different types of the cycle which will get work in case of the boiler. We will see how each and every cycle will get worked. First we will see the coal. Coal, this is the coal which is stored in the bunker. From the bunker the coal will get supplies to the coal mill. Coal mill will produce, pulverized coal mill that will produce the coal. Function of the coal mill is to produce the powder coal. So with the help of PA fan pressure, this powder coal will get spray inside the boiler. Coal will get powder into this mill, then powderized coal will get spray with the help of this PA fan pressure into the boiler. Okay. Here inside the boiler we have to burn this coal. We have to do the combustion of this coal here. For the combustion process here is required. So where this is the second circuit, the air, where to FD fan is given there, post duct, which will suck the atmospheric air from through this duct. It will pass through the air preheater. In the air preheater it will get hot, and hot air is get supplied to the boiler for the combustion. So coal and air will combine there, and one fireball will get produced there. So in this way coal and air will get mixed and combustion will take place, heat energy get evolved in this section. So while burning this coal, the fireball is created there, the flue gases will get created. That flue gases will flow in this direction. It is called gooseneck structure. It is having the highest temperature in this region. Then the temperature goes on decreasing. So flue gases will flow in this way. This way, through this pipeline, through air preheater, then it will get through chimney. From this point, it will flow to the ID fan, to the chimney, then to the atmosphere. Okay. Whatever the coal will burn there, some ash will get created. That ash will get collected toward the bottom side, and some light particle of the ash will get flow with the flue gases. At this point, this area is called the air preheater. It is a heat exchanger actually. Through one side is combinedly, it is having the tube and shell structure. See, from this part the air, cold air will get flow to this exchanger. From this pipe the hot air, hot flue gases will get flow. So due to the temperature difference, the hot air temperature will supply some heat energy to this cold air. Then this cold air will get heated, then heated air is supplied for the combustion. So By doing this, what will happen? Whatever the combustion will take place properly, combustion losses will get reduces, and less, it's more amount of heat energy will get liberated indirectly. Okay. So in this way, flue gases and air cycle will get implemented there. Third is how the water will get flow. This is the point. Before this point, there is a feed water pump. Through the feed water pump, the water will get supplied. Water will get supplied from this pipeline through heat exchanger. This heat exchanger is called the economizer tube. Through economizer, the water will get flow to the drum. So it is shown in the green color, because in this part water is in the water will get heated. If we are enter here from this point, the cold water is entered into the economizer, it will get heated only. Steam is not created at this point. So only in the single phase water is present in the liquid state only here up to this drum point. From this drum, this downcomer is there. Through this downcomer, due to the gravity, the water will enter into this down header. Through this gravity only, gravitational force only, through the pipes will get distributed, or the water is flow through the water valve tube. This tube is there. This is the water valve tube. Means the water will get come like this. It will flow from this point to this point, from this again to the boiler. So remaining this sub branch is there. If some water will get move like this, it is get attached to the wall of the boiler. That is why it's called the water tube boiler. From this tube, it will flow like this. In this way, the water will finally it combines here and finally goes to the steam drum. Okay, so in the drum, there is a separation of water and steam. Upper part will contain the steam, lower part only is the water. The circulation will goes on, continue in this cycle. Okay. And from this part, upper part of this drum, the steam will get flow through the upper pipe through the again to the boiler, and that part is called the superheater. Means again steam is created, but again we have to heat that steam. That's why it's called the superheater. And finally it gets supplies to the turbine. From that superheater steam, finally work will get extracted. So in this way that boiler will get worked. As you seen here, one device is called the air freighter, another is the economizer. These are the boiler accessories which are used to increase the performance of the boiler, or which is called the energy saving devices. Suppose consider if there is no air freighter, directly we are sucking the air, means we are taking the air from the atmosphere and sending to the boiler for combustion. Without preheater means we are supplying cold air for the combustion. In that case, combustion will not take place properly, less amount of heat energy will be evolved. By installing the air preheater, due to that it is possible to supply hot air to the combustion. By doing this, we will get more amount of heat energy, means some that much amount of requirement of coal will get reduced. Secondly, we are supplying the hot water to the drum, and this water will get heated in this economizer. This is the last stage of the flue gases. From this it will get flow to the atmosphere. If you not place economizer, what will happen? The flue gases directly will get flow to the atmosphere. That much amount of heat will get flow into the surrounding without utilizing. Means here we are utilizing this heat to heat the water before sending to the drum. So these are the two devices which will show the energy. Now we will see the some points of that is boiler energy saving opportunity. There is feed water heating using economizer. Already you have seen it, economizer and air filter, which are saving the or which are the energy consumption device. Okay, one thing is there, complete, this is the complete, this is the boiler. This is a complete, this is the boiler. Inside there is a fireball and the high temperature flue gases are present. So proper insulation has to be done at this point, at the outer wall, at this side and all these things, so that losses should get avoided. What will happen? Outside temperature is low than the inside due to the temperature difference, due to the conduction, convection and radiation. By radiation, some heat will get flow into the surrounding. Means that much amount of heat is get reduced from the boiler. Means that is loss of boiler. So we have to reduce the losses so that energy will get consumed. So in third point we mentioned that with control of our air burner, avoid radiation and convection heat losses. So these are these optimize the air fuel ratio, clean boiler tubes. Okay. Cleaning of boiler tube is given there. You have seen that these are the tubes of the boiler. These are the water wall tubes. These are the superheater tubes. What will happen during operation? These flue gases carrying some fly ash with. You are burning coal here. So burning by after burning a coal, ash will get created. That ash will get through with the flue gases. So that may get. That flue gases will get accumulated on this tube, which act as an insulation between this heat energy and water. So this ash will not get removed. What will happen with the due to the higher temperature, scale formation will take place there. Scale formation will take place there. So at appropriate timing, this soot or this ash has to be removed from this tube. So number of methods are there to remove the ash from this tube. We'll not discuss in detail, which is not in your syllabus actually. But proper care has to be taken there in order to remove the soot or the ash from the tube. Otherwise, lower amount of heat will get flow to the water. More amount of heat energy will be required to convert the water into steam. So reduction of scaling and soot losses, reduction of boiler steam pressure. Variable speed control for boiler feed water pump, controlling boiler loading. These are the some points. By using this technique or the methods, we can save the energy while generating a steam into the boiler. Okay. Now we'll see another point, that is energy conservation in lighting and electrical appliances. You know that these are the general topic. I think each and every student is knowing about it. Just we'll read about this slide only. In house we are using the fluorescent lamp, electric tube and CFL, okay, and many such electrical devices which require electrical energy. Some tips or techniques are given there to how to reduce that energy while using lighting in your house. Here mentioned that replace tungsten filament lamp by energy efficient fluorescent tube, and we have to replace with the CFL or any energy efficient lamp, CFL or any LED lamp, to replace that with the fluorescent tube. Install mirror reflector, turn off unnecessary light. Use lightning control operated by photo sensing relay or movement sensing relay. Use light colored wall paint. Okay. Provide skylight in the room. Use tiny switches with electronic devices to turn off while in sleeping mode. These are the some points which is written here or mentioned here. By using this, we can save energy which is required to lightening of house. Okay, as used generally when you paint your house, generally paint a light color paint and use the skylight in the roof so that lightning will get. Lightning effect will get more into the house within using this small number of lights. Okay, so this is complete about this unit. Up till now I discussed the energy conservation in boiler, energy conservation in air conditioning, energy conservation in refrigeration, energy conservation in lighting and electrical appliances. One more point is there, energy conservation in pump, and again energy conservation in fan blower. So energy conservation pump, this image is, I am showing the image here. I think everyone has seen this pump. There are number of types of pumps are available in the market. Submersible pump are there. centrifugal pump are there, rotary pump are there, reciprocating pump are there. But generally, in most of the time, you are using the centrifugal type of pump. So this is the picture of the first pitch. This is the picture of the centrifugal pump. Another, this is the rotary pump. This type of pump generally we are using in the house to the hand pump. What is the function of the pump? To supply the fluid from one place to another, or to increase the head of the fluid. And this is your assignment. What are this energy conservation tips in pump? So complete this assignment till date 28 April. It's up to 28 April. We have to supply this. We have to write this assignment and submit to me before 28. That is, assignment is on energy conservation in pump. What are the energy conservation tips in pump? Okay.